20th Century Fox producer lands at New York with good business news from Europe.
Very happy to be back and report that in Europe, American moving pictures are more popular than ever before.
I grew up in Mississippi, and one of the few names I knew was Zanuck.
There was a tremendous dynasty in the Zanuck name.
To say that it's a resonant name is an understatement.
When I started in movies, certainly Daryl Zanuck was a big name and had been the head of Fox.
You couldn't be in Hollywood and have any respect for the traditions of the industry and not know the Zanucks. Colonel Daryl F. Zanuck, you know, is an autocrat.
As much as I obviously heard a lot about Daryl Zanuck, the first thing that comes to my mind when I hear the name Zanuck is Dick, because Dick was somebody that I worked with.
People think they hear the name Zanuck and they think, oh, well, his dad gave him a job or this or that. Absolutely the opposite.
I met him surfing up in Malibu years ago, and that's how we met, and we got along pretty good, except he would, he was a wave thief. He wouldn't allow anybody to take any wave. You know, he's really competitive, really competitive.
If you want to be a producer, you want to be in this racket, and you want to do it right, I would study the Richard Zanuck.
I was born in December of 1934, and since birth, practically, I was involved as a bystander, as a fly on the wall, so to speak, at the studio, at the beach house with my father, who was entertaining a lot. So I was used to being around at a very early age with major stars at that time. I remember Orson Welles used to come to the house a great deal and do magic tricks for me. And my father was very friendly with Eisenhower. Wendell Willkie spent a couple of nights in our house when he was running for president. I had snowball fights with Ernest Hemingway in Sun Valley. And so I wasn't intimidated ever in my life by the magic or the power of stardom.